Gay days, less controversy, it says right there in the front of the Sun Sentinel. Here's a picture of these screaming queens on there. And you know something? See, I used to be one of those people for all, up until today, as a matter of fact, but I'm doing a quick turnaround, so to speak. I was always opposed to this crap, all these gay pride parades and all these gay days at Disney, which is kind of like an oxymoron, you know, or is it redundant? Something like that. Every day is gay day at Disney. But I was always against that because I thought this, you know, just reinforces the ugly stereotype of all these silly, swishy, mincing queens, you know. But you know something? Now I like it because it pisses off the goyim. That's why I like it. It pisses off all these phony baloney, in-the-closet, pseudo-intellectual, right-wing Christians, okay, who are probably busy drilling glory holes right now. That's right. They're doing it for old glory. Hallelujah. It says the event began 8 years ago simply with a note posted on a computer message board. At first, only a smattering of people turned out for it. But as opponents launched boycotts of Disney and organized protests against it, the event continued to grow. Even that fag Neil Rogers likes it now. How do you like that, is what it says. Now it encompasses four amusement parks in Orlando. It lasts for 5 days. Organizers say it draws as many as 100,000 people. And you want to know the name of the guy who started gay days at Disney? Wait till you hear this. You better sit down, folks. I'm telling you right now. I learned this myself. I almost spit my coffee on the floor, and I don't even drink coffee. I almost spit it out. It's annoying that someone is unable to just let people have a good time, says Doug Swallow.
Oh, my God.
Organizer of gay days. Are you ready for this?
No.
Now, I didn't think you would be. Exactly. You know my motto, when in doubt, spit it out. But not Doug. His name is Doug Swallow. That has to be. He had to make that up, didn't he? Huh? It really has taken on a life of its own, Swallow said. There's just something about that. I'm sorry. It just, I don't know. It rubs me the wrong way, so to speak. Gay Day organizer, Doug Swallow. Man. And that goes on. I'll get into the thing about the bitch there from, where was she from? From Boston? Yeah, from Boston. Came down to Boston with her kid. She was all bent out of shape. Too bad, sweetheart. Okay, get used to it. Get with it. We'll see you on Church Street in Toronto. We'll see you in like any real city in the world where the guys are walking around holding hands. We'll see you down there on South Beach. I bet they're holding it on South Beach. I'll bet you they are. They're holding it right now. 9 minutes after 11 at 560 WQM. We know.
God?
Here comes the FAGs.
Woo! Yeah. The FAGs.
Here comes the FAGs.
Just
wiped
it off my chin. Oh!
We'll play with your member.
Oh! Gay guys got your back. Remember that. Because that's where we're looking for love. It's where your crack's at. The fetish held by me. FAG. I got less facial hair than a lesbian. So don't make fun. Don't poke your nose at the queer cake boy lifestyle I chose. Tuck your gay jokes and start being silent, because you might get a taste of homosexual violence. Because we don't play, your butt's my target, like a dog in his territory. Market. When you see us with our Ray-Bans on, we're just signing the park that we want to get our hands on.
We are the FAGs.
We're the FAGs, sister. Ooh.
We don't perpetrate.
And don't you forget it.
We are the SAG.
Really all kind of hard to swallow. Now let me see you just prance with me. Just prance with me. Now slide. Ooh, right there. Let me see you do some waist bend. Oh, perfect. I make wrist limp.
We are the SAG.
That's it, baby. Just, whoa. Now look what you went and did. Oh, I gotta wipe this off.
We are the SAG.
Oh, Jesus, it's everywhere.
Showtime, big and fairies.
Does anybody have a moist towel head?
We are the SAG.
Okay, look, let's cut this crap out. You're no Judy Garland.
So does Doug Swallow or what? You think Doug Swallow?
Uh-huh.
Anyway, it's 11:15 at 560 WQM. The Hank Goldberg Show from Shula Steak 2 at 2 o'clock. We got Talking Baseball with Donald Z. Brennan at 6. pregame show at 6:30. Orioles at the Marlins. The Marlins are red hot. They won 5 in a row. Is there any?
No.
You can almost feel the interest building, can't you? Joe Costello wants free tickets for the Yankee games this weekend, walking around here with his Yankee jersey on. Pretty embarrassing, Joe. So anyway, going back to this Gay Days thing in Orlando, says in the week before Gay Days, a coalition of conservative groups was rebuffed in its attempt to air anti-gay advertisements on local television stations, declaring that homosexuality is learned behavior that can be changed through religious faith. Here we go again with the crazy religionists. The advertisements ran on 4 Christian stations instead, talking about preaching to the choir. On Saturday, 2 twin-engine planes sputtered through the blue sky above the pointy spires of Cinderella's castle with dueling messages, hoping to grab the attention of the throngs below. And it goes on about Tanya Brown frowning at the small groups of men and women dressed in red and holding hands or kissing. She had come from Boston to Disney World with 3 children ages 8, 9, and 11. We planned this as a special experience for the kids, she said. They're spending the whole time asking me, Mommy, why are those men doing that? And probably Mommy ought to say, none of your goddamn business. Let's go, in the little world there. What do they call that thing? That little, that
the small world.
It's a small world. Yeah, it's small. See this? It's small. Well, I bet you the glory hole consistents are real busy up there this week.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man. Can you see that? Those gigantic drilling sounds you hear all around the Orlando area up there. Oh, here's a call from Orlando right now. Hello.
Hello, Dale.
Yes, sir.
This is Doug from Orlando.
This isn't Doug Swallow, is it?
Oh, yes, it is.
All right, here's Doug Swallow.
Oh!
Hi, Dale. I just wanted to call and thank you for your support of our event.
I think it's great. I hope you piss all these goyim off big time.
Well, the reason we decided to do Gay Days was because of right in the middle of the park, you might have seen, is a big silver ball. We just love it. It's just great.
Yeah.
And we're all wearing red, and we're crowding the local areas. We've brought a lot of business to the Orlando area. They love us here.
Of course.
And the hotels are packed, and we're packing them.
I bet you are. So, you're packing it.
We're going to hold it next year. We're going to hold it every year.
And the event, too, yeah.
We're going to hold it.
So let me ask you the question that all America is wondering right now. Does Doug swallow?
Doug swallows. Yes.
No.
Sure he does. But the interesting part at the end of the article, now this is in the Sun Sentinel down here this morning, it says in 1998, dozens of protesters lined an access road to the park condemning the event, but on Saturday, except for the banner on that one airplane, open protest at the park seemed to have vanished.
Well, that's because we killed all the heteros up here.
There you go. If you can't beat them, shoot them.
New meaning to the word gay bashing. It's reverse gay bashing.
Okay, Doug. Well, listen, they're tracing the number, and they'll be out to get you in about a half an hour.
Yeah, we love you.
Okay.
Bye.
See ya. That's Doug Swallow. What? From calling all the way from Orlando. He was checking it out. He does swallow, too, by the way. What? He swallows, okay? He's one of those guys that swallows, and you like anal sex and all, you know. I'm an old fart, okay? I'm from the old school. I take whatever I can get. 5670560 #560 on the AT&T wireless line. And you'd be shocked.